Hi. Future engineering is a process of taking unrefined raw data and converting it into meaningful futures that your model can understand better and provide a better decision boundary. To give an example, think if you are a retailer and you want to target your customer who you think will not do business from you again. So basically what you are doing, you have your customer information, you have your customer transaction information. You're taking this raw data and trying to create futures to understand the recency of the customer visit. The recency can be today's date minus the last date the customer made a purchase. That can be the recency. The frequency of customer purchase. So basically, number of times the customer purchased with you for the last 7 days. Number of times the customer purchased in the last 14 days, last 30 days, last 60 days. So basically, you're taking the data and creating multiple futures to understand the recency of the customer visit and the frequency of the customer visit. So basically, by creating such futures, what you're feeding to the model may be able to better understand whether the customer will come back and purchase from you or not. So that's what transforming your raw data into meaningful insight. Now, coming back to future engineering, the future engineering can arise out of your domain understanding. You might have some understanding of your business already, and you want to incorporate that understanding as futures into your model. It can come from your data analysis or exploratory data analysis phase as well. When you are taking the raw data and you are exploring the data, you may find some insight which you can convert into futures. Sometimes the futures can also come from an external data provider. So typically, like you are kind of trying to measure if a particular customer will default, and you have the customer information, and you want to kind of maybe use some external third party provider who can give you more information about the customer, like what is the customer external delinquency rate, whether the customer has filed some bankruptcy or something like that. So the futures can also be from an external data provider. There are two steps in future engineering. The first step is more algorithm specific, or you can also call it as data pre-processing step. So most algorithm expects the data to be perfect for it to work correctly and efficiently. In some models are more sensitive to outliers. Some models may be some models may work better if the data is scaled. Like gradient descent algorithm converges faster if the data is scaled for it. Some algorithm might require your categorical values, rather like most algorithm requires your categorical values to be numerically encoded. And more specifically, some algorithm requires this category encoded value to be one not encoded so that no order in the data is maintained. Right. To give an example, if you take this particular scenario, in the chart you see data with the data points with an outlier in it. And if you see the regression line, basically because of the outliers, the regression line is distorted and the slope is pointing towards the outliers. And basically this model has a high residual error. Whereas after the outlier treatment, if you see the other model, after the outliers are removed, the data fits the line better. So sometimes like your model may be more sensitive to outlier and you want to do an outlier treatment. The second part is future engineering from domain understanding. So this can be future that represent time aggregates or events. It can be your customer behavior pattern or the customer journey that led to your business. It can be a count of frequency ratio of a particular entity that you are trying to model. It can be like bucketing your data in such a way that a non-linear relationship can be made linear so that your model can understand the data better. Now, there are plenty of scenarios. There are like countless scenarios in which you can do future engineering, and there is no predefined way or better way. It all depends on your creativity and curiosity when you start analyzing your data and try to implement it. The benefit of future engineering is you can keep your model as simple as possible. Even a simple algorithm with the right set of engineered data can give a pretty high lift in performance. The second thing is you get better explainability of your model. Since you know what futures you have created, you can create a more explainable model. The third is you can remove unwanted bias in the model, right? It can be having the data can have some underrepresented scenarios or something like that, which you want to handle. You can handle it to future engineering so that your data outcome is not biased, so that your model outcome is not biased. In the next set of videos, I'll be talking about some scenarios of future engineering. As I said, future engineering really comes from experience and the data in hand. There is no the right way of doing future engineering. It all depends on your exploratory data analysis phase and how you want to model that particular future so that your model can come at a better outcome. I'll be taking to some of the scenarios. So stay tuned. Thank you.